Thanks for coming by, Mac.
As you can see, how impossible it'd be for us to meet at your place or at my office. What with all the sharks circling and all.
Yeah, well, I barely made it in intact. I mean, I just kept saying no hobbling glay. It seemed to work.
I'll remember that. I have another job for you, Mac. That is, if you're interested.
What kind of job?
It's a top secret project involving the future of the LQ.
This job involves checking out large plots of land across the river. I'm looking for property that's accessible to bus and train routes, no more than 20 minutes from town, and preferably close to the river.
How large?
Very. I'll provide you with the specs.
Well, that would help.
A couple of ground rules. Avoid cute at all costs.
Cute?
No cows with velvety brown eyes. No apple orchards, no horse farms, no kennels. And for God's sake, no children, schools, retirement homes, orphanages, hospitals.
Which leaves us?
A garbage dump would be just heaven. But I'll settle for junkyards, auto wrecking yards.
Well, how about one of those abandoned strip malls that went under when the economy went south?
Perfect. The bigger the eyesore, the better.
Moving the incinerator, eh?
Sorry. No hablo inglés.
Well, why me, Ned? I mean, why not send one of the legion of employees you have at ELQ on this scouting trip?
Because news like this travels fast. You know what it's like when people start gossiping around the water cooler.
Actually, I don't.
Lucky man. Nonetheless, this is a preemptive move. I'm in no position to lock anything down. I just want to be prepared.
Is there a time frame?
Sooner rather than later.
I'm on it.
Great.
Work little Nedley wants, it's work he's gonna get.
What are you doing?
Rock and roll schedule in black and white, so there'll be no confusion as to what's expected of Mr. Eddie Main in the Isle of Wight.
Oh, good! Yeah, that's progress. That's great. Wow.
Yeah.
This is a serious schedule.
Well, hey, that's what he asked for, right? He wants to promote his CD. This ensures he's gonna promote it to the max. Of course, I have prior commitments to the company and to Miguel that prohibits me from being on the road for that long. But that honor, my good friend and partner, belongs to you, huh?
Oh. Okay, but you realize I've never done this before, right?
Oh, yeah, but don't worry. I mean, it's not difficult or complicated. You know, all you gotta do is, make sure that your artist stays out of trouble, he gets to the gigs on time, and, well, the rest of it you just make up as you go along.
You know, I really, really want to thank you for your vote of confidence. I do, but I'm not really quite sure that I am buying this. You just want to get Ned out of town, right?
He's the one who wanted to get back to work. Besides, this is a perfect chance for you to start taking more responsibility around here. Huh?
All right, well, I'm just looking at this, and I mean, I realize that I'm new, but, well, I mean, I don't know if Ned's going to be able to handle this schedule and still take care of his job as head of ELQ.
No?
No.
Oh, gee. What a shame. Well, I guess he's just going to have to make a choice in his life.
Lois, come on.
Stop. It's a lesson he's got to learn. Even the great and powerful Ned Ashton can't have it all.
How do you spell Barrett,
Miss Barrett,
please?
Oh, that's B-A-R-R-E-T-T. That's Brenda. Grand jury, please tell us what you think of the court.
Well, I just...
Okay, well, wait a minute! I will say something. Here, thank you. I would just like to say that Edward Quartermain is one of the nicest, most generous men I've ever known. And he's like a father to me, actually. And I just think that it's totally unfair. I think it's really unfair, actually, that you would
accuse me.
No, what are you doing? You do not speak to the press on behalf of this family. Is that clear?
I was saying very nice things.
I don't care. You throw them a crumb and it starts a feeding frenzy. Don't you know anything about the pack behavior of wild animals?
Well, I'm beginning to learn about it from living with this family. And don't order me around. You need me.
For what?
To protect you from Lois. Boy, does she have it in for you.
I don't have time for you right now.
If you think I'm leaving, think again. You have no idea what I went through to get here.
Oh, poor baby, what happened? You show up with limousine, get a flat tire?
Have you seen the rat pack camped outside the front door? I had to climb out Jason's window, slither down the veranda roof, crawl through grandmother's rose garden, and then sneak down the delivery driveway. But I don't mind, because in the end, it brought me right where I want to be.
Slither, hmm? Somehow that seems so appropriate for you. Well, while you're here, you might as well take a gander at this. It's the promotional tour schedule for the Idle Rich.
Oh. Uh-huh. I can handle this.
Look again, okay? Did you see the gig in Schenectady? Hmm?
Hmm? I love Schenectady.
Well, what about the side stop at University of New Hampshire?
A wonderful institution.
Well, I'm still trying to squeeze here in Connecticut in there somewhere.
No problem.
It is the tour from hell.
I don't care. I am up for the challenge.
Time will tell if you're up to the rigors of a real work schedule.
We can do this. In fact, I'll make the company jet available for the tour.
No, we can't afford pilots and fuel and all that other stuff.
I'll cover the expense.
You absolutely will not. You'll learn to travel on a bus like the rest of us normal people, and don't even think about using ELQ as a distraction, because I simply won't allow it.
All right. Nothing is as important to me as our music and you. And I fully intend to prove that to you.
Prove your devotion to the music, because that is, after all, the business we are mutually, contractually obligated to conduct. And business is all it's going to be.
It'll never be only business between us, Lois, and you know it.
No! Don't delude yourself, Mr. Chief Executive Officer. Because I'm never going to forgive you. And I most certainly will never trust you again.
You won't even give me a chance.
I gave you a chance. You blew it.
You know, it must be very nice to be able to go through life and never make a mistake.
I have made plenty of mistakes. I've also learned to accept the consequences that go along with them. There is your copy of the schedule. You know what? I will send it to you. You can have your secretary type it up for you, okay?
Well, we're off and running.
What was that all about? It was a professional difference of opinion.
Look,
that's all.
Look at you, see, why are you getting yourself all aggravated when you know that I am supposed to be the go-between?
Well, you weren't here, were you?
Well, I hope you know, Lois, I have no intention of playing referee between you and Ned for God knows how long. Either you can work with your ex or you can't. You decide.
Okay. My apologies. There's no reason why Ned shouldn't be treated with the same respect given to Miguel or any other artist on this label.
Thank you. I like that answer.
No matter how big of a lion, hypocritical snake in the grass.
Lois!
It was a momentary lapse. That's all.
Look, Lois, consider yourself indulged. From now on, we start acting like grown-ups. You got that?
Any word from the grand jury?
No, not a peep.
Is that a blessing or a curse?
Oh, don't worry, Grandmother. Maybe tomorrow.
That I didn't miss anything important.
Justus Ward is in the hospital. He was beaten within an inch of his life. Or doesn't that qualify as important for you?
Jason, I think it's terrible. And I have from the moment I heard. So just calm down and tell me how he is.
Ruptured spleen, multiple internal injuries, broken ribs, and that's just on the inside. Try to imagine what you would look like, Ned, if two thugs beat you to a pulp. It's not pretty.
Oh, please, it's horrible.
Jason, I told Justus and I told Sean that I had nothing to do with these threats nor with this attack.
I wouldn't condone it, Jason, and I don't appreciate the implication. Now, we have enough to deal with.
Okay, then did somebody just please tell me something? Why is it that anyone who poses a threat to this family seems to end up in the hospital?
Coincidence?
Right. Well, I'm beginning to wonder. When's my turn?
Oh, how could you say such a horrid thing? I want this discussion stopped.
Well, listen, that's fine with me. Look, why don't we just watch the news? Maybe they know something we don't.
Count on it. He is a major player in the ongoing controversy over the ELQ's proposed toxic waste incinerator and the Charles Street community's well-organized opposition. Mr. Smith, it's a pleasure to have you with us here today.
Thank you for having me.
I understand that you have an announcement that you would care to make.
Well, as you know, I'm a member of the ELQ board.
Don't you wish?
What the hell is he up
to? This is doing to the Charles Street neighborhood. I've decided to resign from the ELQ board. As a matter of conscience, I couldn't possibly remain active with a corporation that is capable of cold-heartedly pushing ahead with a project that is so passionately opposed by the good people of poor Charles.
Oh, I mean, shame on you.
Well, that's
I can't listen to this hypocrite. I'm going to my room.
But let me ask you this question. Why
God, he's good.
Such as yourself,
shut up, all of you.
Who I'm quite certain has a substantial stake in the success of ELQ, take such a radical step.
Ms. Hill, money isn't everything. No. The straw that broke this camel's back was the horrendous attack on Justus Ward. I'm not pointing any fingers, but as I see it, it seemed to have come out of a concern that this one committed man was so vocal against the incinerator project. But why? He was, after all, a human being with rights and feelings and convictions. I mean, he should be held up as a role model. But right now, he's fighting for his life.
Oh, good Lord, give the man an Oscar.
Then I have the courage of my convictions, and that is a model that was so movingly set by Mr. Ward himself. I am offering a $25,000 reward for information leading to the arrest and prosecution of the person or persons responsible for this criminal and immoral act. He will have justice, and I don't care who that person or persons might be or how highly placed in society they are. They will pay.
Turn it off.
Well, I've seen enough to put me off my dinner.
You can't think that people will buy that act.
They don't know Damian as we do.
Grandmother, you alright? What's wrong?
I mean, what's wrong?
Here's some water.
Here's
some water.
Get some water. Yes.
There, that's better, sweetheart. That's much better.
Are you alright? Is she alright? There must be something I can do for you, madam.
Thank you, Reginald. You're a dear man.
Grandmother, if I can...
No, don't, please. Everyone stop fussing. Is it any wonder that my head is spinning with blackmail and poison and deceit and...
I am so sorry, my love.
Oh, Edward, it's not only the Bradley Ward case. Somebody in this house tried to murder that horrible Katherine.
All right, that's it, cuz. It's time to cop to the truth here before you wind up killing Grandmother.
I didn't do it.
Ned, it's gonna come out eventually.
Excuse me. Junior, stick to what you know, which is virtually nothing.
No, I'll tell you exactly what I know.
Can I have a moment?
What? What is it, Reginald?
I think I might be able to shed some light on the whole Katherine thing. I know who tried to kill her.